Christ the Lord?
Yeah.
Well, there are a couple of names I haven't heard, and I may have missed them. And Miss Barnell, nobody knows who Miss Barnell is. She used to go by him. We call it Santan. She did a lot of things. I can't remember a lot because, like I say, that's been a long, long time ago for me. And I don't want to forget Mrs. Lucia
Rucker.
Right. I know somebody's mentioned her name up here. I may didn't hear.
Right.
But Ms. Rucker, that's where I got mine.
Yeah, she was, Ms. Rucker was there. She was next door.
Uh-huh. She taught over there on that side. And I cannot remember who was on this side with Ms. Rucker. But as I've gotten older, I look at those ladies. They didn't teach one grade.
Yeah, they
taught four grade.
Yeah.
Four, maybe five.
And everybody in the same room at the same time.
Everybody's in the same classroom. And when you were there, you just kind of raised a lot of sand and talk. And they were very respectful ladies. I just can't get them out of my mind. My daddy used to call Miss Lucia, Aunt Lucia. All my life, I remember him calling her Aunt Lucia. Okay, well, when I was growing up, you were aunt, you were uncle, you were Aunt Lucia. We were just aunt and uncle. I found out through genealogy, she was Aunt Lucia. So, you don't know, this is Weatherford, small town. We had people coming in from different places.
Yeah.
I'm going to call them the All Mill Group, because that's where they live. Their name were L.C. and Courtney Wright. They would come from the old All Mill, the school here. L.C. and Courtney Wright. And they came in on the train. That's where their family was working. They were, I guess you call them nomads now, because they travel around place to place by the train. And they stopped here to go to school for that year. And that's when we had a hill to play ball on. And this girl, she couldn't speak very clearly. Well, you know, you can speak clearly than me. I'm a laughing. But if my daddy ever saw us laughing at anybody who couldn't speak clearly, you were in trouble.
Yes, absolutely.
And Miss Lucia, she's one of those ladies. You do not do that to other peers, as I would call them. That wasn't the way you treat people. I learned more from Mrs. Lucille as a teacher. And like I said, I can't remember who was on this side at that time.
You know, she was from nowhere. She owned the school.
Miss Connor. Her daughter came on me.
Yeah. Miss Connor, those ladies, we teach our children dirty things.
Sorry.
Brother and granddaughter right now, I told her she's going to be pregnant because she's a talker. She's going to be a politician somewhere. She don't forget anything. And I'm sure these little young people out here, they're the same way because they are of that generation. When I was growing up, and all through my life, I heard that the people would be weaker and wiser. And it scares me.
Yes.
It scares me because I can see the weaker. And I can see the wise. And I can see the wise trying to take over the weak. We got a war going on. We're going to be in another war in the next 3 years.
That's right.
I pray that I am in good health, that I can stay here and do my duty as a citizen, as an American, and help. Because I remember, I know I don't want to get away from the school, but these things came through the school. When the people came through, that's why I learned something about other cultures and where they live and how they live.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, to come out of this school, get on the bus, go to the back of the bus, not this girl. I didn't go to the back of the bus. I went to the middle of the bus. Bus driver never said a word to me. Some lady got what I'm going to call what it is. don't want anybody to be embarrassed and not being ugly. I'm just telling you what happened. There was a white lady. I was sitting too close to the front of the bus. She got up before the bus driver took off. I heard the bus driver, she was sitting there. She looked at him. You're not gonna make her move? No. Well, out of respect from what I learned from Mrs. Lucille, I'm a child, I don't say nothing. I'm grown, growing up at that time, not 12, 13 round the bus. You don't, he wouldn't make me move. That lady got upset. She wanted to get off the bus. But I came from a neighborhood, I don't know if you're black, white, green, red, purple, or yellow. That's where I come from, in my neighborhood. We were the only black people in my neighborhood. And that was the East Side kids. We were the East Side kids, my family. Because there was no other black people over here. The only other black people on there was Mr. and Mrs. Alexander, who lived up on the corner. And there was a lady named Geraldine, lived in the middle, so on Jameson Street. But I said all that to say, coming from this school, and from my parents, from my father, and my mother, you learn how to treat people as people. Mm-hmm. In my neighborhood, you let some people move into the neighborhood, the white, and you weren't used to this neighborhood, I didn't fight. My white friend fought you. You've been in trouble again. I didn't have to say a word, but we learn how to live together. And that's what I'm trying to teach my grandchildren now. You learn. And I'm telling you, my little grandbaby's making me go back a way back to go to school and think about some things. Because I have to tell her what it is. Because she'll ask me why. And then I go and think about, well, you're going to be a newspaper lady because you got all the dough. Why don't you go for and why? It's amazing to me to see this school look so beautiful. Yes. I mean, that's due to restoration, of course. But I can see the old fading boards. I can see this. I can see that. But it just, I'm just so proud of the teaching that I had. And I hope that I'm instilling in my grandchildren the things that they need to think they love when I'm no longer here. And to those little children, don't lie to them, because they're going to remember it. They will remember it. You think, well, she's 3 years old, how you going to remember that? I told my daddy something one time. He said, my daddy looked at me, he said, who told you that? I said, nobody. And he looked at me, and he walked off, he came back. He said, nobody told you that, I won't tell you what was said. He said, nobody told you that, I said, no. He said, okay. But he told me after that, after I was grown, about that story. And he said he wanted us to always, always treat people as though they were your next little brother. Because you never know who you're going to run into, or what year, when, or where. And when I got the baby on the bus, finally, she went back there and she sat down. She was mad. I've never seen a fight woman that was so red in my life. She was mad because the bus driver wouldn't make me move. Now, we just going from Mineral Wells to Cleveland. We had to go from Weatherford to Mineral Wells to go to Cleveland. That was the bus ride at that time. That lady finally got off that bus. When she got off the bus, she looked at me. I just looked at her back. What else would I have to do? The bus driver came up and said, are you okay? I said, yes, sir. You know she wanted me to make you move. I said, I kind of guess that, sir. He said, I told her, you've been on this bus longer than she had, and she didn't like it. Where she was sitting, she could go to the back of the bus. Everything that happened to me, I will never forget that day. That was an awesome bus ride.